It is time now for the Rhody Roundup. We are chatting about some of the most entertaining headlines of the week. Let's meet our panel. Joining us this morning, comedian and Rhode Island native Paul Mecurio joins us this morning. Jess from 92 Pro FM and Russell, I've said that probably a bazillion times, if not more.
Yeah.
And Russell Davis from Spike TV.
It's the tan. Your brain is crying from the sun.
I think that's probably.
Is it really from the sun or is it spray on?
No, you know what I did? I fell asleep in the sun about 2 weeks
that's
ago.
That's what happens when you drink during the day.
Yeah, I grabbed a sandwich. I sat on the back deck, put my head back, thinking, it'll be fine. And that was 20 minutes later, half hour later. Yeah, it wasn't pretty. First, let's talk about this. Actress Michelle Keegan was just named sexiest woman in the world by FHM magazine, beating out Kendall Jenner and Jennifer Lawrence. What do you think makes a woman sexy? Who do you think is the sexiest woman in the world?
Well, I studied pictures of this woman extensively.
I did as well.
With the lights off. And I will tell you, I don't see it. The eyebrows, not my cup of tea. Who wants that? All the creepy Facebook posts are going to say, I've been following you forever. I fall asleep in the sun. Please call me.
It happens.
Well, the thing is that what I found most disturbing is that Kris Jenner did not pay enough money for Kendall to be number
to
one.
To get on the list.
That was unfortunate. And then the other thing is that Margot Robbie is in at number 7.
I know.
And Ariana Grande is at 6. What?
Yeah.
Ariana Grande is like 12 years old.
I know. Exactly. I know. Yeah.
Well, you even saw some articles that would mention Kylie, and she's like 17. Mm-hmm. And so you're kind of going, well, I don't think we're going to touch that at all. Right. But I didn't even know who number one was. Unfortunately, I had to look her up.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Yeah, studying. Yeah.
Paul can show you.
Yeah. Bruce Jenner is very upset. He was number 2.
All right. Another actress who is making headlines this week, Hilary Duff, revealed the details from her first Tinder date. So what celebrity would you want to find on Tinder?
Oh.
Hilary Duff.
We can help you with that.
That's a good one. Yeah. Well, I know that Clint Eastwood's son, I don't know his real name. I don't know. I just know his as a son. Scott or something like that.
Oh, I know his name.
He is a good find, and they actually have his profile picture on Tinder, but it's not him, so some guy is claiming that he's him.
So you're married, but if your husband gave you one...
One pass, it would be... Justin Timberlake, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a flyby.
Yeah, I don't see it. If you're on Tinder and you see Hilary Duff, you go, no way, that's not Hilary Duff.
I agree.
Right. That's just a dude with breast implants. There's no way that you even believe that's Hilary Duff. Right?
I agree with
then
you.
Then you're like, whoa, Rihanna, wow. I really, like,
But she doesn't know other people. Like, she has to be on Tinder. Like, she doesn't have friends that be like, hey, I could hook you up with a cool guy.
That's what I
don't know. Tinder, there's something fun about Tinder. And I do the Tinder thing, and especially being traveling, and it's kind of exciting.
Is this confession time?
I'm very much on Twitter. I'm like, hey, I do Tinder. And I think it's kind of cool. It's exciting whenever you swipe right now. I don't have a girl that I think that I want to match on Tinder, but I will go through and then pray that it matches after I swipe right sometimes.
Are there anybody who you've like gone, wow, I can't believe that person's on Tinder?
All the time. Yeah.
You?
Yeah.
Married, man. What's going on?
Look at this. I know. It's confession.
Really get priority.
It's confession time.
I'd like to find Bernie Madoff's wife.
Yes.
A lot of money.
A lot of money.
Single.
Right.
Just
probably falls asleep at 9.
Yeah. And then you go out on the street. You go out, party it up. Next thing, a new study shows that chewing gum might be helpful in getting a song out of your head and unstuck from your head. Would you try it if it worked? And what are the songs that get stuck in your head most? Are there songs? I mean, not just
that Car for Kids commercial. I swear to God, someone's going down. I can't take it.
But there are songs like you're listening on the radio, listening on TV, and they get stuck in your head.
How does the gum work? Is it laced with LSD? How does that work?
I don't know.
Yeah, Where do we get that gum?
Yeah, exactly.
Too many songs stick in my head. I will definitely try this. I didn't think like a Sam Smith, "Stay With Me," "Just Shut Up," and even Ed Sheeran. They're just whining all the time.
I agree.
Like,
oh my!
Just knock it off. Like go have.
I want to. Can I hug you?
Yes.
I'm gonna hug you for
the second.
Because I. I so agree with that. I'm so
God,
over.
I'm yeah, I'm sick so of over. Complaining.
It only prevents it though. It doesn't get rid of it after you already have the song stuck in your head, right? So you have to preemptively decide before you have a song stuck in your head.
Is there anyone in your head that gets stuck? Any song?
It's just whenever I used to be back behind the bar, it was kind of hit at the time. Yeah. But right now, I got a lot of Calvin Harris stuck in my head.
Happy birthday. That's the one that sticks in my head. Just constantly, happy birthday.
Well, guys, thanks so much for joining us here today. We got a lot more coming up.
That's a nice shirt on you, by the way.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
It goes with his tan.
The lavender brings it out.
We're going to catch up with Paul in just about a little bit about his career and his big show coming up at the Comedy Connection this weekend. And we'll also be chatting with Russell a little bit later about his event at Twin River. It's a very busy day.